Let's summarize some facts about implicit solvers, the simplest of which is the backward Euler method. The big benefit is the stability. We can use large step sizes, and stiff differential equations don't force us to use overly tiny step sizes, which results in speed. Some types of simulation are almost impossible without implicit solvers. Think of cloth simulation and the simulation of water waves. These types of simulation may be forbiddingly slow without the speed offered by implicit solvers. The big disadvantage of implicit solvers is that they are, well, implicit. We get equations that we have to solve, which is hard to do or can be even impossible to do with standard functions. Mathematicians have come up with quite a range of methods to address this issue. For instance, in a predictor-corrector approach, you use an explicit solver, such as the forward Euler method, to predict the value for the next step and then use an implicit method to correct it. Actually, Hoynes' method that we learned about in a previous unit is of that type. Or you can use iterative methods to numerically solve this implicit equation, not with pen and paper. And a second disadvantage of implicit solvers, most of them tend to lose energy in physical simulations. We saw that the forward Euler method, an explicit solver, increased the energy. Implicit solvers tend to work the other way around, tend to lose energy.